Hey, what's good, y'all? I got my tutorial coming through today that I've been super stoked on bringing to you guys about how to do graffiti onto your miniatures and make it look realistic and look like real graffiti and just do it with a freehand. And it's really easy, you guys. And I think it came out looking pretty cool. So let me show you my tutorial on realistic graffiti. All right, so the first thing I do is figure out what I want to write on there, put on there, and I just Google up whatever word I want or whatever. So I just chose dice. I found this dice piece. I'm not a graffiti artist. I don't claim to be. I don't know shit about it. I used to do some, but I'd rather not get arrested, and I would rather paint my miniatures than other people's shit. So I just a disclaimer there, but first off, you're just gonna want to start with your image, and then I just whatever I want to paint on, as you can see, I just start blocking it out with the background color, so you can get your shape on there. Looks like it says dick, but yeah, so that's where you're gonna start out just to get your shapes, the beauty of this is it does not have to be perfect and it'll look cool, trust me. And it's really good on terrain like this terrain piece I was doing for my other tutorial. So I'll show you the next step. I'm just continuing to block in these colors, this time the blue. And as you can see, like I'm not even really being very careful about it, but like you do not have to be artistic, and this will definitely come out making your stuff look more realistic. So that's why I like it. So just bear with me and I guarantee it will shape up. And you're just building up these colors from the bottom, basically. And anyone can do it. I cannot stress enough how simple it is. So let's see how it looks on the next step. All right, so I just done some work just bolding in the black shadows and just copying how it looks in the picture. Simple as that. Now I'm gonna move on to the next part. So I just went ahead and did that highlight. I'm just using this crappy brush and just crappy paint. Like, it does not have to be perfect, but you can see we're getting there with the look. So what I'm gonna do next is take some white and highlight that even a little bit more on the light color. And then I'm also gonna do a little bit of the red that they got on there and try and just make this look a little more detailed. And I'll show you that in a moment. So there you have it, folks. I added some more color with the green and red, and then I defined the turquoise with a white highlight with some little star kind of looks. And then I threw in a freehand UG dub. So that is, I think, where I'm gonna leave off on this one. So yeah, it's really that simple. And as you can see with some miniatures on here, I think it adds a cool look to it. And I find it a lot less stressful than most of your typical freehanding where you're trying to be perfect on every little detail. 'Cause this, you can go in, you can change things. If it's too hard, you can simplify it. You can use totally different colors. You can use different words. Like, I copied this style. You can see I kind of just did my own style on the top. It's not as nice, but hey, it looks cool. It looks unique on the table. And I'm really looking forward to doing more on our Necromunda terrain and also on Fallout terrain because I think we could come up with some cool ideas. And that's really what it's all about, is just having fun. And I find this is a really fun little painting tutorial to do. And I hadn't seen anything else like it, so If you enjoyed it, go ahead and give us a like, give us a subscribe, and throw down a comment if you have any ideas on how to make it better. And yeah, thank you for watching. We'll catch you on the next.